Has Christianity always been one of the religions in the world to you?
Oh, hallelujah. Christianity is not a religion. Neither is it a joining of a church and doing the Christian things like praying and giving and so on. Hallelujah. Christianity is the outworking of God's own kind of life received into the spirit of a man. Whoa! This divine life in the heart of a man makes him righteous, keeps him healthy, divinely guided in life, prosperous and victorious. It gives you the ability to enjoy intimate fellowship with the Father and have dominion on this earth. Hallelujah. This is what awaits you if you will wholeheartedly believe that Jesus is the Son of God raised from the dead and personally confess Him as the Lord of your life. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Join Dr. David Binder on the Good Life Devotion every Monday to Friday on this channel and receive truth that will usher you into exhibiting the divine life. Kindly note that you can enjoy the Good Life Devotion on these other platforms at their stated times. Do choose the most convenient one for you or switch to another in case of a broadcast challenge with your usual platform. By all means, don't miss the Good Life Devotion any day. Now, welcome to today's episode with Dr. David Binden.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How are you doing? I believe this is a beautiful Friday. And we are going to try to see how we can round off on this subject of the practice of giving according to the scriptures in the kingdom. And of course, though we try to round off on many platforms on Friday, remember we always come to you on our special weekend episodes of Metro TV, 10 p.m. on Saturday and Sunday. And on Sunday, we have an omnibus package on Light TV, 4 to 6 p.m. You can't miss it. But this is a session that no matter what you've listened over the week, you can sit down and then eat all at a go. Imagine 2 hours of word upon word. Don't be missing that. It's a good place to enjoy. Praise the Lord. Wow. So we are going to go forward today and look at the angle from where we're going to discuss the subject of the practice of giving in the kingdom. But just before we pray, I want to remind you that we have had 4 episodes already. We began introducing ourselves to the subject. Why is there this seeming controversy about giving in the body of Christ? And we made it clear that there's no controversy. What you are seeing as controversy, this one arguing here with conviction, that one arguing with conviction, and then the other one arguing here with conviction. They are all talking scripture. So who should we take? Don't say that and get confused. You have to know that they are talking from one of a certain perspective. And God allows this because He deals with us in different ways as we mature through different levels. So God Himself does not have a problem with somebody who is practicing a certain level. The only thing is that the result of his life will be at that level. God expects that he will grow to the next level. For instance, if you are functioning within the good will of God, God is okay with you. If you don't grow into the acceptable will, yes, you will live and die and all that. But ultimately, your life will end up in eternity at that level of goodwill. If you learn the scriptures and allow God to teach you because you know God progresses and you get to acceptable will, you will live better in conformity with his perfect will. It makes you a greater person in the coming kingdom for your good. If you allow God to further take you to his perfect will, whoa, you are in line. And so in that kingdom, we are going to be shining as stars at different levels of brightness based on what we have done. Did you allow yourself to work at the goodwill level, at the acceptable will level, or at the perfect will level? It's the same thing in terms of expressing giving. I mentioned to you 3 levels. We have the level of a baby, the level of an adolescent, and the level of a mature person. We have gone through that through the week. As a babe, you give from a carnal perspective of an obligation. You give to people because they have sown to you and you owe them a debt. At the adolescent level, you give as a means of sowing to reap. Then at a mature level, you give as the expression of your divine nature. To be a blessing to your world. Because you are already blessed with everything. At this level, we'll take ourselves further. And today we're going to look at I'm I'm trying to combine some things here because I wouldn't be coming to you somehow with a new topic over the weekend. But what is an emancipator? You need to get it and feast on. We're going to look at how to combine the 2 days in one. So we're going to look at the process with no judgment. And in it, we're going to look at two major areas. One aspect is on the truth that you need the process of growing from giving as a babe, giving as an adolescent, to giving as a mature person. And then you need to arrive at a place where you judge no one anymore concerning this subject. And it's not because we are just being apologetic and we don't want people to... No. It is because we are bringing you truth. And when you know truth, is there are a lot of things that men are fusing about on the earth and a lot of hullabaloo about things here that God is wondering, why are they arguing? Because I am God and I have no problem with that, no problem with that, no problem with that. Okay? Right. So we must come to the level of God where we look at people and relate with them from their level of maturity. And if the whole body of Christ grasps this, many of the contentions will not exist. So the process with no judgment. Let's start off. Father, we give you praise for the light you have brought and continue to bring to us. We are made different. And the surface of the earth is renewed now and forever. Amen. Wow. The process with no judgment. 1 Corinthians chapter 13 verse 11 is our main scripture for the first part. It says, when I was a child, I spake as a child. Oh boy. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. Oh, how else should the Bible be clear? You see baby Christians criticizing mature ones that they are some way. You see mature ones pouring it down on the babies. But if you are mature, you were once a babe. And if you are a babe, don't remain a babe. Grow. And when you grow, put away childish things. And there are those that have grown, but they just don't want to throw away childish things. Oh, praise God. Oh, boy. But the scriptures are clear. If you are a child, you will speak like a child. You will understand like a child. You will think like a child. But there's nothing wrong with you. A Christian who is still a child will think about his connection with his old family and will be thinking of curses flowing him from his family and will be dealing with these things as forces. The one mature should not condemn him. He's thinking like a child, speaking like a child. When he's exposed to his nature in Christ, he realizes that thing never existed. And so the mature is to get him truth, to deliver him, as it were, from babyhood. But then, if the one who is not mature thinks that this is all there is, and then begins to fight the one who is talking about the mature level, then he will never come out of it. But if he knew that it is my level, and so he begins to look for more truth to come out of it, he will grow to maturity. Are you following this? When I was a child, I spoke like a child, understood as a child. I thought as a child. Oh, but the good news is, when I became a man, I put away childish things. Let me just take time to read to you in the man's spirit. If you are born of God, giving is your nature. And you will only get confused if you try to suppress it. You know, there's this carnal perspective of people who are sometimes in the body of Christ, they just don't want to let go because they don't understand the power of giving. So they always want to fight every teaching on giving, so that it will make sense, they can remain with their little, you know. Imagine, God is not looking for your, what does God need from you? Who has given to God that he may pay back to him? And no true pastor is looking for anything from you. True pastors teach you to give for your own sake. Those who are not true do that for their own sake. But just as a true pastor will teach you how to handle your marriage, teach you how to grow in prayer, teach you, he also teach you how to express your giving in the kingdom. There's no true minister of God that teaches on giving for himself. Because ideally, at the level of being a minister of God, God is your source. And that's even at an adolescent level of speaking. And not man. So any Christian who tries to fight, oh, I don't want to give offering, or I don't want to give tithe, I don't want to give first fruit, you are only frustrating your own internal wiring. You were wired to live by giving, because giving is the expression of your divinity. And I taught that very well in another episode. If today you're hearing me first, if you don't get it, go to the second and third episodes and get it there, so that you don't get yourself into a state that you don't understand. What I have to say here, that because giving is your nature and shouldn't fight it, what should you do? Put aside emotional attachment to denominational doctrines on giving and embrace the plain truths of the scripture and rapidly mature to the next level. You know, you can be in a denomination that says that, I don't believe in tithe, we don't give tithe, we don't give first, we don't give all these things. Okay, be there. The earth is waiting for you. If you sow, you will reap. You can be there and remain a struggling Christian, only recycling your salary, until the only thing you can do is when you are about 60, 70, and you spend all your savings on medical bills. And that is, you just live a normal life because you have not engaged the earth enough. That will be okay for you, but you are the one losing. But if you look into the scriptures and realize that, could this thing be there for everybody? And realize that it is my denomination that is limiting me. Come out of it and begin to engage what is available for you in the scriptures. Why live at the edge of life when there's so much abundance for everybody? Just because you are boxed somewhere? No. And if you're also in a place where the mode is give, if someone is yet to grasp it, don't let a person feel like curses are going to dry him up because he's not giving. No, that's not what God said now. In Christ, if someone is in Christ, he's blessed. What he will not get is the harvest. And the harvest is not a blessing, and neither is its absence a curse. The only thing is that the person will not enjoy his state of being blessed. Are you following this? So come out from denominational attachment to doctrines and approach these truths plainly. We said that even God our Father, knowing that his ultimate goal of giving for his children is to bring us to a place where we give as the expression of our inexhaustible nature to our world. This is what he knows, that's the ultimate. Even that our Father, he's patient to allow people to go through all the stages to that final level. So if God is this patient, why will we, his sons and daughters, not be patient with each other? I've been to places where people say, well, in our church, we just give offering, we don't give tithes. Okay, that's good for you. Relax and practice, but there's a high level. If a light shines on you, move ahead. If you don't want to, just remain, God doesn't have a problem with you. And you're okay. It's just that the quality of life will be different. And the amount of things you control will be different. But if you know the truth and you choose to stay at one place, that's you. God hasn't forced you. We'll put it that. The conclusion of the discussion is this. Depending on your current level of maturity, confidently and cheerfully engage all the scriptures of that level of giving. Whether it is giving to the poor, whether it is giving offerings, whether it is giving tithes, first fruits, kingdom projects, and so on. If you are at the level of giving under obligation, give your offering to the poor under obligation. Give your offerings under obligation. Give your tithes under obligation. Give your first fruit under obligation. Do all of that. Do it well, but do it with a cheerful heart. Knowing that, I don't really understand, but I'm cheerfully doing it because I know it's a level. And you'll be amazed at your peace and glory at that level. But why you are doing that? Because in every kind of giving, one thing stands out, 2 Corinthians 9:7, God loves a cheerful giver. So are you giving under obligation? Give cheerfully. In Romans 15, if you read from verse 25, the Macedonians and the people in Achaia, they gave with all their heart. They were glad to do that, even though they were giving under obligation. Now, if you move to the adolescent level and you are giving by faith or giving as a means of sowing and reaping, do that also cheerfully. And then when you come to the level of the mature, Akayababa. At that level, of course, it will be an expression of joy. So what do you do? Depending from this station, you know where you are. Wherever you are, don't do the thing with any force. Do it with cheerfulness and do it confidently. Don't feel condemned by somebody. So if you're a babe, don't feel condemned by the one who is giving by faith. And if you're there, don't feel condemned by the one who is giving as an expression of divinity. Are you following? Then, what do you do? Gradually grow to put away giving by obligation and step into giving by faith. Then as you are there, do all that is there. Engage all the scriptures there. Practice it until you have mastered that level where you realize, what should I even give to get? I'm above that level. I'm resources. What can I get? I have everything already. Then from there, you now move to giving as an expression of your God being. Are you following this? Why are we saying this? All the stages are necessary to bring you to the final stage. Give you an example. Anyone who has never learned to give under obligation will never let go enough to believe in the principle of sowing and reaping. So there are people that their hands are closer than one that they have used a G-clamp to tighten. So to them, anytime they see the scriptures of sowing and reaping, they will not even hear it. Why? They have not practiced even letting go under obligation. Because the more you let go under obligation, you begin to feel good letting go. Then that opens your heart up to see the realities of letting go as a means of sowing to reap. Are you following? So that baby level of giving is necessary to move you to the adolescent level. Now, when you step at the adolescent level, my God, pour out, give by faith offerings, give by faith tithes, give by faith first fruits, give by faith for kingdom expansion, give by faith to the poor, give by faith for projects. And what are you doing? You are engaging to harvest. You are engaging. So give profusely. Because I say that if you give sparingly, you reap sparingly. If you give bountifully, so engage in everything bountifully. Even if it means you are giving in a way that doesn't sound correct to men. My wife and I have emptied our bank account several times. We don't know how many times. Empty everything and there's nothing. There were times that we gave almost everything in the home. That even there was a time I wanted to give and I look at the house. What to give was not there. These are not crazy. It's like, you see, we came to a place where letting go was easy. Giving vehicles out. Things like that. Oh, praise God. You see, so when you get there and you engage that, the more you engage, the more your heart opens up. The more your heart opens, then you get to a place where you don't give because you have. You give because you are. Then it begins to dawn on you, So anytime there is a giving to do, or you see a need and you want to sell, you don't look at, do I have, don't I have? You look at, I want to do this. Then before you realize the supply comes, then you realize that, there is a place I can get to that I don't need to have money in my bank account. I don't even need to have physical things. But if I want to give, I can give. Then you realize that, then the door opens for you now to begin to see how God gives. You are here. When you ask for money, does God go to Bank of Ghana to mint money? No. It is his nature. When Jesus wanted money to pay for tax, what did he do? You think fishes are swimming in the water always with coins in their mouth? No. That coin was produced by divine nature and put in their mouth. And he went and picked that particular fish and paid tax. Only a person who does not believe in the supernatural would think that the supernatural does not cover money. If supernatural can cover healing, raising the dead, traveling, vehicles, everything, what is money that the supernatural cannot cover? Don't limit yourself. Jesus proved it, that money can be produced supernaturally. Praise God. So, the process of growing from a babyhood giving through an adult an adolescent to the mature is there. So everyone must go through the process. Each process opens you up to begin to believe the truth for the next level. If you don't master the baby, you can't get to the adolescent. If you don't master the adolescent, you can't go to the mature. So if you are at the level of giving by faith and you're just doing it scantily, you will stay there for long. Pour yourself at that level. And then you get to a place where you're able to do things without having. Then you realize that I'm beginning to do them because I am, no more because I have. Then that shifts you to the level where you give as a God being. I'm going to go on a chat, but when I come, I'll take the second part. What did we say? The process with no judgment. So with this that you know, what should you now do when you know somebody who is at one level that you are not? I'll be right back after this break. This book, Daddy Holy Spirit, is a classic on how to walk with the Holy Spirit. Walking with the Holy Ghost is very important in being relevant in this final move. And this book is to help get the Holy Spirit restored to his place in our lives as our Father and restored to the church as the Father of the church and to be able to walk with him. And everyone must have a copy. Your life will never be the same. Praise God. So with this, once you know that the process is there, everybody will go through the process. The ultimate thing is that you don't judge anybody anymore. So Mr. Intelligent Man, Enlightened Man or Woman, no more sitting on social media and talking against first fruit, talking against tithe, talking against this. Where is your level? The one that is giving is at a certain level. You are also at a certain level. Let's read. Romans 14:4. Who are thou that judges another man's servant? To his own master he standeth or falleth. Yea, he shall be holding up, for God is able to make him stand. So if God is making the person you are criticizing stand, why are you wasting your time? Are you the judge? No more judgment. Let me just take my time to do it. Said from here that from today, when you see or hear people contending or defending doctrines on giving according to their understanding, just relax, smile, and reserve your spiritual energy and emotional energy. Because the way people can actually write and talk and say things when it comes to money and giving, I say, why are you wasting your energy on things that God is not even, God is relaxed about? You're wasting your energy. Use that energy for something great. Said that they are talking from their level of maturity. So whoever is saying, with what you know now, you will know the level that they are talking from. Judge none of them, but rather assist them to also get this truth and become settled as you are. Because of these things I know, when I see these things, whether they're on social media or in churches or not, I just laugh. I smile. And I'm looking for means and ways of getting through to the people, just like I'm doing to the whole world right now. The principle of giving in both the Old Testament and the New are the same before God. I'm talking about the principle. Listen to me carefully now. Why you shouldn't judge. How God prescribed them to the people, the reward systems he attached to them, and the names he gave to them, is not an issue. You could see from the Bible that what really matters is God's overarching plan of getting his children to function as joint heirs of Christ concerning his universal estate. This thing is not about some small money, small tithe, small giving. No, it's about training you to be a steward of the universe. If you are so stingy, how are you going to give life to plants and animals? How are you going to love people enough and pray for their good? So the principle of giving is to train you to become a discharger, a releaser, so that you can release your peace upon people. You can release your joy upon people. It is not about a meager and a quantifiable human offering or tithe or first fruits or those things. The new creation in Christ is actually the actualization of God's dream to administer the blessings of heaven to the entire universe. And that's what God is looking at in training you. So it's not about your tithe. God could have called tithes offering, and it doesn't mean anything. You could have called first fruit giving, and it doesn't mean anything. He gave those names at different times because of the angles of understanding. So tithe, whether it's tithe or first fruit, it doesn't mean much to me. I just do it because that is what... It's like I even wish God would add more giving portfolios so we can express ourselves more. So with what you know now, you regard the process, go through it and grow, and then you judge no one anymore. Father, I thank you. Speak right now. Just bless God. Oh, Mara Kumbara Basundi Rigaba Yoshata Keboro Bosata. For these truths and for the power that has come to change our world. In Jesus' name. Are you watching us? Believe God raised Jesus from the dead. Declare him as Lord. A new life will fill you, and you'll be begotten as a son of God, a new creation. One in the kingdom, and you can practice the kingdom living. If you want this to happen to you, say this after me with all your heart. Say, dear Lord Jesus, I believe with all my heart that you were raised from the dead after you died for the sins of mankind. I know you are Lord now, and I declare you Lord of my life. I am born again. If you've done this with all your heart, you are born again. Remember, I'm going to carry your way again in our special weekend editions on Metro TV, 10 p.m. tomorrow and on Sunday. And on Sunday again, 4 to 6 p.m. on Light TV with the omnibus package of Monday to Friday's message. And then I'll return to you next week again with another special topic. Till then, life is good. Enjoy.
If you just got born again today and would like to fellowship with us, call our numbers displayed and connect with any of our new creatures fellowship branches nearest to you. Dambai, Pasa, Nkwanta, Takrade, Kaswa, Lagon, Tachiman, Tema Newtown, Ashaman Newtown, Tema Ashaman, Gulf City, Nungwa,
Nkonya,
Kolegono Tree speaking, Kolegono Gas speaking, Kolegono English speaking, the Multinationals Church, or our virtual church online. We will be glad to fellowship with you. Do call us.
Thank you for joining today's episode of your favorite Good Life Devotion with Dr. David Bindan. The Good Life Devotion is proudly brought to you by friends and partners of the Final Global Movement.
For more information on how to become a partner, call us on 053-444-6907. Or log on to our website, finalglobalmovement.org. Become a partner today and contribute to the global spread of God's message for the now.
Follow us on our various social media handles and you will be blessed. Don't miss the Good Life Devotion on the channels displayed on your screen at the scheduled times. Till we come your way with the next episode of the Good Life Devotion with Dr. David Bindan. Life is good. Enjoy.